two creative ideas that we can achieve in record time. Let's jump in on Canva and create these beautiful properties logos. Make sure that our alignment and our precision is on point. So in order for us to do that, you're going to go to File and you're going to go to View Settings and you're going to select Show Rulers and Guides. And the rulers show over here. So what you need to do, you need to move your mouse so that the arrows show back to back, and then you click and you hold your mouse and then you move it down to wherever you need to move it. So that's how you add a ruler and a line, whether it's landscape or horizontally on here. Then we're going to use our lines and our rulers so that we know that we are perfectly aligned. We want to be 3/4 of the page. Then you're going to press L for line and you're going to rotate negative 90 degrees and you're going to just make the weight of the line to be 10 and you're going to have to create your line and give space for the name of the business that we're going to be writing. Then you're going to do the same on the other side. Then you're going to duplicate the line and create a house lookalike. So we want this to be just at the middle. And that's 369. So that would be 600. And then we duplicate, we rotate to the other. Once you're done, you can switch off the lines and grids and start making this nice and pretty. So I'm going to switch them off and then zoom in and start aligning them so that I don't have those ugly gaps. Then we're going to highlight our group. We're going to highlight our home. We're going to group it. We're going to duplicate the shapes and we're going to reduce it, edit just below or inside the home that we first created. Then we press T for text and we change the font to Horizon. Nice big font. And our second design looked like this. Let's jump in on our third design. With our third design, we're not going to complicate things. We're just going to press T for text. And this is what you need to do when you're creating logo designs. Fonts on Canva as well as shapes, you are able to make the fonts your own. In other words, you can register them according to Canva rules. It allows you. So familiarize yourself with beautiful different fonts that Canva has. So with this particular one, we're going to be using the name of the company and we call it Rye. But because this is property, this is home, we go and we look for architectural type of fonts. So when I looked for architectural, I found a beautiful font that's called Akikoku, and it is home-like, business-like, house-like. It's a structural kind of a font that we can use for our design. So because we're going with red, we're going to make it nice and big and huge, like 300-ish around those ballparks. And look at the architect of this font. It's just amazing. You press T for text. D Let's use the open from computer format because I've been told I use a lot of templates, and I'm going to take it slow because I've also been told that I go fast. So you're going to select open from computer, and then you're going to find the mockup that you've downloaded wherever you've downloaded it. So my mockup is sitting on my external hard drive. It's called the black wall. So you're going to double click on the file that's called PSD. If you've downloaded a mockup and you have a JPEG and a PNG and a PSD, always pick the PSD file and then it's going to load. Once it has loaded, you're going to double click where it says your logo here, but on the checkered box. And then it would show you how you should add your design. This is an example, so we're going to hide the example by clicking on the eye. Then we're going to find our 3D that we've downloaded it from Canva. So I'm going to go to my downloads and I'm going to go find the design that we've done. And once it's loaded, I'm going to just align it and make it nice and big, as you've seen on the example that the designer showed us. And then I'm going to press Command S or Control S to change it to Smart Object. You could also use File, Save as Smart Option as an option. And once it's changed, you're going to click and select the first tab to find your design that has been converted to 3D. And it's gorgeous and it looks like that. Then you're going to download this design by going File, Export as the format that you want, and then you're good to go. If you enjoy these tutorials, you're more than welcome to go to our playlist and learn some more on how to use Photopea. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on our next video.